हेलो, वेलकम बैक। सो बिफोर वी गेट इनटू द फाइनल डिटेल, फर्स्ट वी विल हैव एन ओवरव्यू ऑफ द रिइंफोर्स्ड कंक्रीट स्ट्रक्चर्स। एंड इन द रिइंफोर्स्ड कंक्रीट स्ट्रक्चर्स, कंक्रीट एंड रिइंफोर्सिंग स्टील आर द मटेरियल यूज्ड। एंड कंक्रीट स्पेसिफिकली इज अ कॉमन स्ट्रक्चर मटेरियल, नो डाउट इट इज वेल नोन, बट how common it is and how much a part of our daily lives it plays is perhaps not well known, or rather it is not often realized. Well, concrete is used extensively in the construction of various kinds of building, stadium, auditorium, pavements, bridges, dams, waterways, pipes, water tanks, swimming pools, cooling tower, etc. So it is the most commonly used construction material. And therefore, as a matter of the fact, it is consumed at a rate of approximately 1 ton for every living human being. It is a very huge quantity. And man consumes no material except water in such a tremendous quantities. So that is a vastness of this material. So first, we will take two, three examples of reinforced concrete structures. So this building known as State Trading Corporation Building, and it is also known as Jawahar Vyapar Bhavan. It is located in the New Delhi, and it was designed by the architect Raj Rewal. And this building was built between 1976 and 1989, and it is considered to be an important example of modern architecture in post-independence India. So this building was designed structurally by the structure engineer Mahinder Raj, and this structurally expressive building, it has a varandial girder system, and they are arranged in a plug-on fashion cantilevered from the core wall. Then coming to another example, we have another iconic building as Capital Complex, located in the Chandigarh, and it is designed by the architect Le Corbusier. And this building, this Capital Complex, it is actually considered as the concrete marvel in India. Now we will take another example of a concrete bridge. Now the uniqueness of this bridge is that all the codes, all the elements in this bridge are constructed either using the concrete, I mean reinforced concrete, or the brick. There is no steel sections there, and the type of bridge which is there, it is actually a bow string girder bridge. And in this type of bridge, I mean, it is also known as arch bridge. So basically the function of this bridge is like this. If this is the arch, and if we tie it with the horizontal member, so this horizontal member can be a girder or can be the slab where, I mean, the girder slab where the traffic will be moving, or maybe another horizontal member. So this girder will tie this arch such that, because at this point arch is generally having the horizontal reaction, so this horizontal thrust or reaction, it is generally carried by this horizontal girder system. It is not transferred to the vertical member like here, this one. So it is not transferred to this. The reaction, the horizontal reaction which is generated because of the vertical load running on the girder, it is actually taken by the horizontal member. So that is why it is a very efficient bridge. So this is again a type of bridge which is constructed using the concrete and is considered as a concrete marvel. So now we will discuss the basic objectives of structural design. Well, while designing a structure, it must satisfy three basic requirements. Now, the first requirement is the stability. Now, stability of building is to prevent the overturning or the sliding or buckling of the structure or the parts of it under the action of loads. The second requirement is the strength. The strength should be there so that it can resist safely the stresses which may be induced because of the external load in the various structural members. And the third objective is the serviceability. Now, serviceability should be there to ensure the satisfactory performance of the building or the structure under the service load condition. Now, that means it should provide adequate stiffness and reinforcement to the structure to contain various deformation. Now, those various deformation can be a deflection or a crack width or vibration. So it should be within the acceptable limit. So if it is within the acceptable limit, then we say that structure is serviceable. And beside this, there are two other considerations also, which we ought to bear in our mind. And that is economy and the aesthetics. Now talking about the reinforced concrete construction, it is not the outcome of structural design alone. It is a collaborative venture which involves the client, architect, the structure engineer, the construction engineer, project manager, and the contractor. There may be some other specialist also which may be consulted regarding the soil investigation, water supply, sanitation, fire protection, air conditioning, acoustics, etc. So basically the reinforced concrete construction project, it involves actually the three phases. Now the first phase is the planning phase. So in this phase, basically it is the job of the architect or planner to conceive and plan the architectural layout of the building to suit the functional requirement of the client with due regard to aesthetic, environmental and economic considerations. And structural feasibility should also be there, and it is a very important consideration. And for this, structural designer has to be consulted. So that is being done in the planning phase. Now in the design phase, once the preliminary plans in the planning phase, it has been approved, then the actual details of the project have to be worked out on paper by various consultants such as the architect, the geotechnical engineers for soil investigation. Similarly, if we talk about the case of structural engineer, so what structural engineer will be doing? So his task will be involving the selection of the most appropriate structural system, then estimation of loads on structure, then structural analysis for the determination of the member force and displacement which may be induced by the various load combinations. And after that, the structural design of the structural elements is done. And in this, it involves actually the calculating of member size, calculation of reinforcement details, and also deciding the material required for safety and serviceability. And then after that, finally, the submission of working drawing is being done by the structure engineer. And these structural drawing, the working drawing should be detailed, should be having details enough so that it can be stamped as good for construction. So once it is stamped for good for construction, then it is being sent to the construction site. Now, then we get into the next phase, and the next phase is the construction phase. So in this phase, the plans and design which were conceived on the paper in the first two phases, it is actually translated into the reality. Well, a structure may be well planned, it may be well designed, but it also has to be well built. And for this, the responsibility lies not only with the contractor who is entrusted with the execution, but also with the construction engineers who undertake supervision on behalf of the consultants. So that is the main phase of reinforced concrete construction. Now we will continue our discussion in the next part, because in the next two parts we will be having a general discussion on the structural systems. Thank you.